In this diagram, we'll examine the factors leading to parturition or childbirth. And we're going to look at three main avenues here. We're going to look at factors that initiate that parturition. We're going to look at factors that increase the sensitivity to hormonal and paracrine agents that are going to contract that myometrial layer of the uterine wall, initiating those uterine contractions to push the baby out. And finally, factors that help complete that parturition. So let's start on the left with initiating that parturition. And the initiating hormone is CRH, corticotropin-releasing hormone, that's coming from the placenta. Normally, we think of this as a hypothalamic hormone, and it is, but in this case, it's being released by the placenta, and it's going to act in both the maternal and the fetal systems to stimulate the production of adrenocorticotropic hormone, ACTH, from the anterior pituitary. That will act on the adrenal cortex to release cortisol in both the maternal and the fetal systems. Now, in the fetus, this cortisol is going to help with maturation of some of the organ systems that are sort of last to mature, respiratory tract being a good one. But it's also going to act to increase placental oxytocin, a hormone that is contractile to the uterine wall, as well as contractile prostaglandins. Now, what increases the sensitivity to these factors? And that would be estrogen. If you recall, estrogen from the placenta is rising late in pregnancy while progesterone is falling. Progesterone is anti-parturition. Progesterone has to dominate through the majority of pregnancy because it opposes the contractions of the uterus. Estrogen is the opposite. And in fact, the cortisol is actually going to help with enhancing the conversion of progesterone to estrogen, allowing this hormone to become the dominant one. Estrogen increases the number of gap junctions, it increases the number of oxytocin receptors, and so we're going to get stronger and stronger contractions as this estrogen levels rise. And so here are uterine contractions that are now occurring. Because of those uterine contractions, we're going to get cervical stretch. The cervix is the bottom portion of the uterus against which the fetus is being pushed to basically exit that uterus eventually. And so that cervical stretch actually stimulates oxytocin secretion in the mother. And that oxytocin, as we've seen before, causes the uterine contractions to get even stronger. But this creates a positive feedback loop because the contractions cause greater cervical stretch, which causes more oxytocin, which causes the contractions to get stronger, and around we go until we get parturition or childbirth.